Hot News Update Coronavirus on May 22, 2020. Note, this is a collaborative video made between Travel for All and Knowledge of Coronavirus channel. Please respectfully welcome everyone. The following is the remarkable news most on May 22 as follows. 1. U.S. News. All 50 states of U.S. are at least partially reopened as the country heads into Memorial Day weekend, even though some states have reported a clear upward trend of average new daily cases over the prior week. By refusing to wear a face mask on camera, Trump signaled to his core supporters that he stands with their demands to get the country back to normal, despite his public health officials' warnings about a possible return of coronavirus. The United States is getting closer to the record of 100,000 deaths by COVID-19. After a week of reporting fewer cases of infections in the day below 25,000 on May 21, the number of COVID-19 cases in the U.S. increased again, exceeding 25,000 to 25,964 cases, bringing the total number of people infected to 1,618,678, including 96,220 deaths and 381,774 people recovered. On the same day, Mayor de Blasio also said that the city was investigating 159 cases of rare pneumonia in children related to COVID-19, double the number of the previous week. In other developments, from May 22, New York City beaches will be reopened for people walking or running but not being crowded. Many people have started to use the subway system with a daily density of about 600,000 users, an increase of half compared to the peak in April, but still very low, compared to 5 millions of users every day before the pandemic breaks out. Up to now, New York State recorded 28,540 deaths from COVID-19 and the total number of infected cases was 359,235. Meanwhile, a new study by Columbia University shows that if the social exclusion order was applied just a week earlier in March, the number of deaths in New York would be reduced by about 17,000 and about 36,000 deaths all over the United States. 2. Update the world. As of 6 a.m. on 22/5, according to the Worldometer statistics page, the world recorded the number of cases of COVID-19 acute respiratory infection caused by COVID-19 in the day at more than 100,000, bringing the total number of people infected with the disease reached 5,186,837, including 333,976 deaths. 2. News of Italy. On May 21, Italy reported an additional 642 cases of COVID-19, bringing the total number of COVID-19 cases to 228,006, the sixth highest in the world after the US, Russia, Spain, the United Kingdom and Brazil. Also according to the agency, the number of deaths due to COVID-19 in Italy on the same day increased 156 cases to 32,486 people, ranked third in the world after the US and UK. In addition, Italy reported an additional 2,278 COVID-19 patients recovering, bringing the total number of successfully treated cases to 134,560. Meanwhile, the number of COVID-19 patients under special treatment in the country continued to decrease by 36, currently 640 cases. 3. English News. To date, the UK recorded 250,908 cases of COVID-19, the fifth highest in the world, including 36,042 deaths, the second highest in the world. In the UK, Health Secretary Matt Hancock said the country began piloting the COVID-19 test to get results quickly from May 22. According to Mr. Hancock, the purpose of the program is to help people immediately know whether or not they have COVID-19. If the model is successful, the test kit will be rolled out nationwide in the next 6 weeks, with millions of people being tested starting as early as July. Secretary Hancock said the tests and results would immediately change the way Britain is controlling the COVID-19 pandemic, allowing people with negative results to quickly return to work often. 4. Egyptian News. On May 21, the Egyptian Ministry of Health confirmed 774 more cases of COVID-19, the highest increase in new cases within a day of detecting the first case in mid-February. COVID-19 cases in Egypt are currently 15,003 people. According to the ministry, Egypt also reported 16 more deaths from COVID-19, bringing the total number of deaths from this dangerous disease to 696 people. Meanwhile, the North African country also had an additional 223 COVID-19 patients fully recovered and discharged, bringing the total number of successful treatment cases in Egypt to 4,217. 5. News of Russia. To date, Russia has recorded 317,554 cases of COVID-19 infection, including 3,099 deaths and 92,681 recovering cases. On May 21, Moscow Mayor Sergei Sobyanin signed the decision to initially relax strict quarantine measures in a city where nearly half of COVID-19 sufferers in Russia. According to the decision, starting on May 21, business owners in Moscow can receive the right to issue e-pass for employees but still have to minimize the presence of this team at work. Mayor Sobyanin stated, "It is too early for all employees to return to work. Therefore, all organizations in the city need to maintain the maximum rate of employees working on a remote basis." In addition, the car-sharing service in Moscow will be restored from May 25. At the same time, the minimum rental period is 5 days and the tenant must have an electronic passport to travel within the city. The car-sharing service company must clean the vehicle before handing it over to the guests. From May 27, city travel must have an electronic passport and wearing a mask and gloves is still a mandatory rule in public. 6. Palestine News. The Hamas leader in Gaza on May 21 announced the closure of two major border crossings between Egypt and Israel due to a new outbreak of COVID-19 in the Gaza Strip. Palestinian Health Ministry said health experts have confirmed 29 more cases of COVID-19 in the Gaza Strip, bringing the total number of COVID-19 cases to 49. According to the ministry, the sudden increase in the number of cases is due to Palestinian people returning to Gaza through the Rafah border crossing with Egypt and the Erez border with Israel. To prevent the spread of the disease, Hamas also isolated 2,000 people due to concerns that they had been exposed to COVID-19 positive cases recently. An Hamas official said he was considering the possibility of blockade of the entire Gaza Strip during the Muslim Eid al-Fitr, marking the end of Ramadan. 7. African News. In the latest report, CDC Africa, a specialized health agency of the African Union, AU, said the number of confirmed cases of COVID-19 across the continent in the past 24 hours increased by 3,603 cases. New infection on 95.201 in the afternoon 21/5. In addition, the number of deaths from the epidemic across Africa has increased by 85 new cases, bringing the total to 2,997 deaths. About 38,075 people with COVID-19 were cured. According to the CDC Africa, the COVID-19 epidemic has spread to 54 countries, of which North Africa is the continent's most affected area in both cases and deaths. Egypt and Algeria are currently two African countries with the highest number of COVID-19 deaths on the continent. 8. News about the development of vaccine COVID-19. The hope of defeating COVID-19 cheered up all Americans, if not the entire world, when on Monday, May 18, Moderna announced the results of its first phase of testing. Antibodies were created in the blood of volunteers. Along with optimism saved humanity, Moderna shares increased rapidly, raising the value of the stock increased 300% in a year, though not sold any products, according to ST18 magazine. However, the next day, the company's stock price fell more than 10%, because after checking with immunization experts, ST18 Medical Journal said the notice of this pharmaceutical company made only ignition. Blind public opinion with loud statements rather than control data. ST18 magazine reports experts saying that, based on available information from this Cambria MA-based company, it is not possible to know if the vaccine is effective. Experts do not look at the optimistic optimism in the press, they look for data to prove the results of the experiment, because scientists are only convinced when looking at the data. Consistent with the conclusions, and they did not find the necessary control data. 9. disinfectant hand gel that causes car fire. During the COVID-19 epidemic, everyone was trained to wash their hands regularly, so many people had their own sanitizing hand gel bottles in their cars to disinfect hands, but few thought of another disaster. Within Oconomowoc, Wisconsin warns of the danger of having an antiseptic hand gel in the car on hot days. In a notice on the fire department's Facebook page showing a picture of a burnt car door with the explanation that an antiseptic hand gel is made of alcohol, so it is easy to catch fire when the temperature rises, according to WMTV. NBC 15 reported it. If you leave your hand gel in the car on a hot day in the sun and accidentally light a cigarette or near a BBQ, the weekend will be a disaster, the fire department said. In addition to being reminded of a hand washing gel, the fire department also advises against leaving a clear plastic bottle in the car in hot weather. If the water contained in the bottle is transparent, the whole bottle will look like a magnifying glass. Meet the right angle, sunlight through and focus enough heat will burn the object along the way of the sun's rays. 10. Vietnam News. Vietnam has now turned to the 36th day without any infections in the community, the number of COVID-19 cases recorded at 324, of which 266 cases have been cured. The remaining 58 patients are being treated at health facilities across the country, of which 8 patients have had negative test results from one time or more. 11. Swedish News. According to CNN, the data on community immunity has just been officially confirmed by the Swedish Public Health Agency, according to which only 7.3% of Stockholm's population has antivirus antibodies by the end of April 2020, much lower than 70-90% needed to stop the disease.
Sweden has now combated the epidemic with a different strategy, not shutting down the economy and only applying gentle spacing measures in the hope of gaining community immunity soon. With a population of more than 10 million, the country has had more than 32,000 people infected and nearly 4,000 people died of coronavirus as of May 21. Anders Tegnell, Sweden's chief epidemiologist, admits that 7.3% of people have antibodies, slightly lower than expected, but not much difference, only about 1-2%. The Swedish Public Health Agency conducted a test of 1,118 people within a week to determine the immunity level in the community, and 7.3% was the number they found in Stockholm. The results of other regions will be announced later. Sweden's community immunity strategy, which has not received widespread support even in the country, but the government denied that was not their goal when deciding to maintain the economy. The World Health Organization, WHO, once warned that community immunity is a dangerous calculation. 12. Canada News. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau stated that Canada would continue to support the World Health Organization, WHO, even though U.S. President Donald Trump issued an ultimatum threatened to withdraw from the organization due to mistakes of WHO in the prevention of the COVID-19 pandemic that Washington accused. On May 17, Canada and 12 countries passed a resolution calling for an independent investigation into the WHO's handling of the COVID-19 crisis. On May 19, the World Health Assembly, WHA, passed a resolution which called for a fair, objective and comprehensive assessment of international response to the crisis, including an investigation of WHO actions related to the COVID-19 pandemic. 13. Tin Malaysia. On May 22, the Prime Minister's office announced that Prime Minister Muhyiddin Yassin would be separated at home 14 days after an official attending the recent meeting shared by him had tested positive for COVID-19. Regarding the development of the COVID-19 epidemic, the Ministry of Health of Malaysia on the same day announced the addition of 78 new viral infections, bringing the total number of cases to 7,137, including one new death, raising the total number of cases. COVID-19 died by 115 people. 14. Singapore News. According to the Singapore Ministry of Health's notice on May 22, the country recorded 614 additional cases of COVID-19 virus, bringing the total number of cases in the Lion Island to 30,426. Among the new cases of infection, there are 4 new infections in the community. The rest living in foreign labor areas have been isolated. To date, Singapore has 12,117 people are cured and discharged, 10 cases are under active treatment and 23 deaths. 15. Indonesia News. On May 22, President of the Office of the President Hanki Yudhistha said that Indonesian President Jokowi will not hold a public meeting at the National Palace on the first day of the new year, May 25, 2020. Idul Fitri of Muslims to adhere to social divestment measures to prevent the COVID-19 pandemic. Earlier, the Indonesian government imposed a ban on all major religious activities, including a New Year prayer event to prevent the spread of the COVID-19 epidemic. On the same day, the Indonesian Ministry of Health announced an additional 634 cases of virus infection, bringing the total number of COVID-19 cases to 20,796, of which 500 died. Our newsletter is now over. Thank you for always watching and supporting our videos. Knowledge of Coronavirus, Channel and Travel for All Fantas respectfully, and see you in the next video.